3 hours we on HeneH pulls a fish train and crashes. One. Henry was ready at 5 o'clock. There was some ahead to frost. Come on, don't be silly, don't be silly, puffed Henry to the vans. The vans shuddered and groaned, and then there was trouble. The van was in pieces. Henry's driver was furious. You silly engine, just look what you've done. Henry felt depressed. Clouds of fire poured from his funnel into the cold air, and Henry, the commitment, loudly, what's this? Shed and tea. No! Go away! Signal lights shone line clear as they passed. Down means go, and up means stop. So up is still, must mean go back. Come on, Henry, said his driver. Off we go. Stop! You're going the wrong way. Trucks hard into the buffers, but the buffers were the silly trucks were sunk. Oh dear, he said, I am a silly engine and a very naughty one. The kipper is due, said the guard. Who cares, said the fireman, this is good coke.
Crew, we all knew what that meant.
They'll give you a new shape and a larger firebox. You'll feel a different engine and won't need special coal anymore.
With those few words, he'd sentence Henry to death.
Won't that be nice? Yes, sir, said Henry doubtfully.
Everyone knew he wouldn't see him again.
Henry liked being a crew. They often see him pulling the express. He does it so well that Gordon is jealous. But that's another story. Meanwhile, phew, remarked the TSMU, and I'm finished at last. I made it into the real Xbox Nerds collab.
You didn't make it!
How could this happen to me?
It's not fair. I suffered dreadfully, and no one cares. Oh, that's right. You want another story? Well, here you go. Gordon was cross.
This was making James cross.
Why are you complaining all the time?
Because I'm a big blue engine and I know everything. I shall complain whenever I want. You're just a small red engine with ideas above your station.
Why should Henry have a new shape, he grumbled. A shape good enough for me is good enough for me is...
Wow! How original!
He goes gallivanting off to crew, leaving us to do his work. Oh! What?
Well, anyway,
Henry whistles too much. No respectable engine ever whistles loudly at stations. It isn't wrong, but it isn't wrong. Poor Henry didn't feel happy anymore. I suffered dreadfully, and no one cares. Never mind, whispered Percy. I'm glad you're home again. I like your whistling. Later, Henry stopped at Edward's station.
I'm blue.
Yes, of course. Shh. Can you hear something?
Probably the wind, said Edward.
No, listen.
It sounds like Gordon, but Gordon never whistles like that. It was Gordon. He came rushing down the hill at a tremendous rate. He screamed straight through the station and disappeared.
What?
Gordon screeched along the line. At the station, everyone held their ears. The fat controller held his ears, too. Take him away, he bellowed.
the station. Joke wasn't in my coal and me, so here you go. Gordon puffed sadly away. He wouldn't stop whistling until Two-Fifth knocked his whistle valve in place. That night, Gordon slunk into the shed. He was glad it was empty. It isn't wrong, murmured Henry to no one in particular, but we just don't do it. Next morning, Henry was enjoying himself enormously. I feel so well, I feel... Then he saw some boys on a bridge.
Hello!
Oh. The boys didn't wave and take his number. They took my number.
No!
They... Well, call the police.
No, said the driver.
And you keep a secret?
Yes.
Well then, Henry is going to sneeze at those boys. Soon, they could see the boys. Are you ready, Henry? Sneeze hard when I tell you.
Now,
achoo-shoo!
Why is there smoke coming out of Henry anymore?
That isn't smoke. It's steam.
Well done, Henry, laughed his driver. He had taught Gordon and silly boys a lesson with a whistle and a sneeze.